I am Malthe.
And this is our class on the 15th of February. Yes. Okay. So we were talking in previous about how we want a few different visualizations that can help us think of how to dance well and how to make this play to our partner. So we had the bowling ball in our hips, which makes us feel nice and heavy and grounded. We had our dinosaur tail, so imagine it protruding out the back, and so we could lean forward to counterbalance. We had the floor covered in treacle, so it's sticky, so you're kind of stuck to it as you're going around. And we had the floor beneath the floor, so think about trying to dance through the floor that you're on, getting to the one beneath. We had the peach, the giant peach that you throw up and catch, but you've got to absorb it, and you've got to have this nice balance to absorb it. And we had the
pirate ship.
So talking about that feeling when you're at the edge of sort of this collection before you swing backwards and collection before you swing forwards.
So we need rolling from left foot to get a nice.
Yeah, we talked about massaging our feet on the floor and going heel to toe, toe to heel to get this nice swing. So we put that in practice.
And then we looked at a couple of different jockeys. So we did the 8-pound jockey. Roll. Pirate. We did the 6-count. And then we did the weird 8-count on it. And then we did the seesaw. And we used that in the 6-count and 8-count touches.
Yep.
So we look at the 6-count.
And how you can turn that into an 8-count. We talked about leaders keeping this hand up so the followers know to keep turning. We talked about followers keeping your momentum going and not stopping unless you are asked to by your leader.
And then that extra little step. So we didn't really care we're doing another spin.
Yeah.
And then we briefly talk about how you can use these ideas to extend or change any move. So for example, you can do the stand up for as long as you want until you make that pirate ship go back. You could do the swing up.